Oh, hello again. Now, you all know I've got the XJS as well as the XJ6, yeah? So, first off, I was about to get some paint and do the engine bay of my XJ6. But this XJS is due for an MOT very soon. And my handbrake's been playing up for, well, ever since I've had the car, I'll be honest. And I thought, oh, I'll go and fix it now, yeah? So, unfortunately, the handbrake cable's shot, really. I can't adjust it because the adjuster's absolutely corroded and it's just knackered. So I thought, oh, let's do it. I'll go and get a new one for it because it's not that expensive. So I'll put a new one on it. Okay. So yesterday, I went under it and I thought to myself, oh, this isn't too bad. It's quite easy. But I'll give it an underseal while I'm here. Okay. Because I was under it having a look which cable I needed, because someone said there's two. I don't know, I was just looking. And I've noticed that one of the rear brake discs has a piece missing, let's say, yeah. There's actually a piece missing off it. Now, I don't know if it's serious enough that it wouldn't pass an MOT or it's dangerous or anything, but in my opinion, I have to change it. Okay, it's a very small chip on the edge of the disc. Okay, well, it's probably about that big, yeah. I'll show you if I can. So, to do this, I have to drop the entire rear suspension on this. Okay? Now, this is a job that I heard if you want to change the rear brake discs while leaving it on the car, because it's in like a cage, okay? If you want to change it while it's in the car, apparently it causes depression, alcoholism, and thoughts of selling the vehicle, I was told by somebody. They recommended to me you drop the entire cage with the rear suspension and work on it in your garage, because you'll be a lot quicker and it'll be a lot easier. Okay, so today, okay, I'm going to drop my rear suspension on my XJS. Yeah, so like I say, it's not XJ6 today, it's XJS, but let's see how we get on. Yeah, so I've just taken off one of the exhausts boxes. And I think it's knackered. Yeah, so I didn't care about taking it off, I just smashed it off, to be honest. But yeah, unfortunately the other one's like that as well. Now, last winter, I replaced the front pipes, the middle pipes, and the bit that goes over the back axle, okay? And I've deleted the middle box. I bought a proper performance part, okay? But if I remember right, the MOT come up and I just put the back boxes on, and then unfortunately my nan died, and I'll be honest, this last year I haven't done anything to this car. It's not done anything. These pipes were new when I bought the car. I fitted them about 5 years ago, but the car's only done about 3,000 miles, 4,000 miles since then. But yeah. So yeah, I'll replace them while I'm doing this at the same time. Give them a bit of a ripple. Yeah, good. Wonderful. So another thing I'm going to replace while I'm here is the radius arm mount bushes. As you can see, that one there has absolutely had it. My goodness. For some reason, I'm sure there's supposed to be a bush here, like a bump stop. That's always been gone since I had the car, so I'm actually going to put that in as well. So I'm sure that's what's supposed to be there. And yeah, you can see the state of the brake discs. Let me try and get it closer. Yeah, so I'm just going to change them because, like I say, that one I think has got a crack in it, I'm not sure. But yeah, they're a bit too far gone. Plus I could re-bush it all and do all the bushing here. And the handbrake needs new pads on, as well. So, yeah, these springs weren't very old. I think someone had fitted them when I got the car. But I'll give these a paint because they're actually still quite good, I think. Tidy them up a bit. But yeah, generally... not bad. So it's probably a good job I'm actually doing this rear suspension. I'll show you why, yeah? Oh. Yeah, it sort of just fell out. And this one feels a bit gone as well. So I think I'll replace those two. And then the next thing I do is I've got to do all this wheel arch as well. This is all gone as well. My goodness. We'll chop all that off and start again, I think. But yeah. We're getting there. It's just very time consuming. See, it's like someone's body filled this. Rubbish. Yeah. So. we weren't concerned with that at the moment. We just want to get this off at the moment. Oh, it's a nightmare to get that off. Right, let's have another go. So as you can see, we're getting on quite well. I've disconnected the exhaust. Yeah, that's shocking. So I can't get this off at the minute, so I think I've just got to trim that down there to get it off. But that's nothing, I can do that. You can see the state of the discs. Let's see if it will show you. Yeah. They need doing, don't they? So yeah. But good. These are going to be a bit of a pig. Because they've rusted on this side. So yeah, we'll deal with that when we get there. So as you can see, it's going very well at the moment. So it's extremely heavy getting that out of there. So what have I got? So obviously I'm going to give all this cage a paint while I'm here. But you can see the discs are a bit... yeah, they're a bit had it really, aren't they? Let's be honest. Now one of these covers has always been missing on this car, so I've actually just bought a second hand half shaft. I'm just going to steal the cover off it. But yeah, and there's two bushes. I don't know if you can see them in here. Hang on. There should be a rubber bush, I think, in there. Not in there, sorry, in this bit. But unfortunately, I think they're absolutely knackered, one of them is. Not sure which one it is, but we'll have a look while we're here. And yeah. Like I said, I did actually put new brake pads in this about 4 years ago when I got the car, but the discs was knackered really then, to be honest. But yeah, we'll see how we get on. So, from my judgment of this, there doesn't appear to be, I don't know if you can see it in there, hang on. There doesn't appear to be actually any handbrake, nothing left of the handbrake. I don't know if you can see it very well from this photo, but they don't look to me like there's anything left on them at all. It's probably a good job I'm doing this. So there's the chip in the disc. Don't know if you can see it. There it is, a big chunk missing out there. Yeah, so it's definitely about time we changed them. So as you can see, it's getting into smaller pieces now. Okay, this was a nightmare to get out. I had to heat it up a bit. I've just removed the rest of the bushing that was in there, so I've got to clean all that up and make it all nice again, but I had to cut them out. So yeah, I'm still waiting for parts, I'm afraid. So I'm going to do one side at a time and then go to the other side. Okay. Good. Yeah. So some of the new parts have arrived. Yeah. So I was going to just put a sports back box on, but I'll be honest, this car has to go for the MOT in about a week and a half, and I haven't really got time to make any, so I've just bought some new ones, to be honest. Quite nice. Just standard ones, that's all. Okay. Yeah. I've also bought a new set of rear brake pads. Cool. Two track rod ends. The new set of discs for the back. I've got bump stops that I'm completely missing. Got, these are very small. I didn't realise they were this small. Look at these. Handbrake pads, look at those. Very nice. Absolute diddy. I've got the radius arm bushes. That's good. Very nice. And I had to buy this kit because unfortunately my exhaust is missing all the proper fixings and everything. So I've bought the kit to fit the exhaust on properly. I don't actually need half of these, but they'll come in handy. If you ever do a job on the Jag, and also some of it fits the XJ6 as well, so that's good. Now the only thing I am missing is the handbrake cable that hasn't turned up yet. I'm just trying to think of something else that's missing as well. I think it might be just the handbrake cable, but that's the only thing that hasn't turned up. So good. Yeah, I've done one of my radius arm mount bushes, and then there we go, there's the new one. Look at that, it's a lot better, isn't it? I'll just give this a coat in black Hammerite, because it was all rusted. But yeah,
Getting there. Just got all this lot to fit still yet. So let's get going.
So this is probably why the handbrake doesn't work. Yeah, I think they had it. Oh well.
So the disc is off the car. Oh, that's copper grease. Look at the state of this, look. It's eaten into the disc. Yeah, they're definitely... I think they definitely needed a good change. Look at the state of this. You can see why nobody ever changes these, because this is such a headache to change. I'm going to be honest with you, it's hard. Oh, look at these. Very nice. So unfortunately, this is not going very well today. Yeah. It snapped off, went to drill it, and oh dear, it's just rotten, rubbish. The rubbers are going. It's just crap in it, let's be honest. It's just shit, isn't it? So I'm actually on the internet at the minute, just trying just Jags. I've just tried David Manners and no one seems to have any of these. So it looks like I'm going to eBay. Europarts have them, but they want like a lot more money than the people on eBay. I was like, oh, so we'll see. Oh, setbacks. So, unfortunately now my caliper's broke. I've decided to buy two new rear calipers because the other one's just as corroded. Well, it's just as bad, to be honest. I think it's going to be an absolute nightmare. So, unfortunately, I've put my XJ6 now on hold again because I've spent all my money on this one. Okay? But yeah, this is my one that's on the road now. So, I like to keep this one good, if you know what I mean. But, yeah. It's always another thing, isn't there? It's nothing simple, is it? Oh well. So, as you can see, we're getting there. Now, I have actually got the cover for this one on its way, but I think I can fit that while it's assembled. I'll just paint that one. Now, them covers, I looked on the internet, nearly £50 each. £50. I've bought a second-hand drive shaft with two covers on, for £50 with delivery, so I'm just going to steal one of those off. Okay. I'm still waiting for my calipers, so I can't reassemble the handbrake or anything because it's all in one thing. So I'm feeling a bit stumped with it because I really wanted to do one side and then move over to the other side, just so I don't forget anything, how it goes or anything like that. So I'm just going to put the hub on next. And yeah, probably paint a bit of this, and that'd be nearly it for today. Yeah, good. So where are we at the moment? Look at that, new discs on. I've reassembled all this. I've got a cover still. That's still on the way, still waiting. And the grease nipple is also missing off this. So when I get the other drive shaft, I'll nick the grease nipple off it and put in this one as well. There's your disc. I'll have to give it a bit of a clean. I'm still waiting for the caliper. I really hope that that caliper goes on there while that disc is bolted on tight, or else I've got to take it all apart again. So tomorrow I'm going to put this disc in, because I bought two new calipers, well, reconditioned calipers, so we'll start on this side. Okay, so what am I doing now? There's not a lot of room in this garage, so I don't know if you can see, I've just put a new bump stop on. That's never been on the car since I had it. Both sides have always been missing. Now what am I doing now? Oh, this is it. Now, I don't know if this is going to focus very well. So it's getting late at night now. This is part of the bushing for the radius arm. I'm nuts to if I can get that off. I've tried knocking it off, absolutely everything. So I'm going to cut it off right now. So let's get going. So there we go, it's off. About time. Bloody hell, that was all I had to get off. You can see how many times I was trying to hit it to get it off, and in the end I just, where is it?
No, that's not the one. There you go, you can just see I've just started cutting it. Oh, I can't do this one-handed. There you go, I've started cutting it down with this Dremel. This tool is I know it's only a cheap brand, but this is absolutely fantastic for cutting things like that. It's probably the best thing I've ever used. So yeah, that's a bit better. Like I say, I do underseal everything as I'm going. I'm going to do the entire car. It's just I'm just doing the bits where I'm working at the moment, because this stuff, if you've ever used it before, this is wax oil, and it's absolutely terrible for making a mess. So let's go and do the other side now. So, there's a nasty bit of rust here, but this is how it's always been since I had the car. And when I got the Series 3, I looked underneath and thought, hang on a minute, that's got rubber pump stops. So, yeah. I've had to chop these off because they're absolutely knackered. So, let's get going. So, there we go. Much better. Much better. So there we go, we've got the other one off. Yeah, it's not great, is it? Not as bad as the other one though, but yeah, rubbish. So at the moment, I think it's going good. the disc's on. The drive shaft, I've just painted it, so I'm waiting for it to dry and then I can whip that back on. Still waiting for the cover. And then of course I'm going to see all of this, but I'm going to wait for it to be on the car. I'm just doing it in there. But I'll wait for it to be on the car before I understand too much, because it makes a real mess when moving it about. But yeah, not bad. We're a bit closer to being done now. That was the other caliper. That one's not as bad. I'm not even going to touch that. Not even going to try. No. Good. Getting there. So we're now waiting on parts. Yes, that is my footprint. I had to stand on it. So yeah, like I said, we're still waiting on parts. Oh, can't wait. Hurry up. So the discs are on. The suspension's all put back together. The new exhaust bushes are in. Radius arms are on. But I'm still waiting for the calipers. Okay, and that cover. Okay, so I didn't get as far as I wanted to, but we're doing quite well considering I'm doing this on my drive. Yeah, good. So hopefully tomorrow or the next day the calipers will arrive. They can put the handbrake back together again, flip it up, whack it back in the car, bleed the brakes, job's a good un. Yeah, there's still about another 4 or 5 hours, I think, here. But, well, just on this probably part. But yeah, we're getting there. We're a lot closer than we were. We're a lot closer now. I think we're over halfway. So this is good. The brake calipers have now arrived. Look at them. Very nice. Look at that. Fantastic. Oh. Yeah, look at them. Wow, very nice. So look at these. Very nice. Yeah, very happy with them. So next thing I do is the handbrake. Okay. Oh, getting there. I think we're over halfway now. So here's my handbrake pads, look at that. They're good, don't they? I had to make some new bolts though, but that's the thing. So yeah, I think I've done one. I don't know. I've just got to put a bit of safety wire of split pin in here. And I've still got to do the safety wire for the calipers. But yeah, getting there. Good, and then I'm going to paint all this, but I'll wait till it's under the car first. Oh, and I got my drive shaft cover, look at that. Yeah, good.
So I've got the handbrake in. Yeah. Good. I'm just about to put the pads in. Okay. And I found some proper, I don't know if you can see from here, hang on, some proper split pins in there, because there was just a bit of wire in one and one was missing, so I've managed to get a proper pin for it. And then I can, yeah, hang on, I forgot what I was doing myself now. Oh yeah. Yeah, so next thing, I'll put pads in while it's out of the car, it's a bit easier. And then I might lift it up on the jack here in the drive, fit the exhausts, because I think it'd be easier to do it here. And then paint it on the outside, and then it's ready to go back in the car. Yeah, look at that. Oh, I'm so happy to be at this stage. So, it's ready to go in the car. I'm very happy with this. Very good. So, at least we're definitely over halfway now. I've literally got to put this in the car, bolt it back in, connect everything up, put some more brake fluid and put some more axle oil in, and we're done. Look at that.
Oh, hello again. It's going well. Well, it was going well.
As you can see, I've got it's in. Look at that. It's bolted in.
But I've came across another problem. Now, this fuel pipe here has always had like a drip just here. I've just wire brushed it and it's absolutely, it's dripping, yeah? It's proper running through now. So now I need two new rear fuel pipes, which I've just found out that are 125 quid for the two. Because the other one is knackered as well, because that one's leaking as well. Hang on. Bear with me. It's just started raining. This are in the gap. Oh, there's not a lot of room in this garage. So this pipe, look. Oh, look at this. Rubbish. You see, I think this has always been a bit wet. There's always been a drip here, this side as well. And it's knackered now. I think I scratched it with this, not the rust off, because there's no dent in it, and now that one's knackered as well. So I need two new fuel pipes. Now I am hoping, okay, that I don't have to take this cage out again to do it. I don't believe I do, because it has a rubber bit in the pipe, so it flexes. Oh, I hope so. I hope so. I don't want to have to take all this out again. I've only just got it back in again. So yeah, this rear end of this car has turned into a very expensive repair, considering I was just going to put new brake discs on it. Oh, and new bushes and other bits. This has turned into an extremely expensive problem, let's be honest. So it's not good. So unfortunately, this has put my XJ6 Jaguar on hold, which is really annoying. There's a set of wheels I'd like to buy for this XJS, actually. Let's put that on hold as well. So it's not good, really. But hey, we'll get there in the end, yeah? We'll get there. But it's just annoying, isn't it? But it's one of those things. I'd rather repair it now than later, to be honest. So it's better than it going down the road, and losing all your petrol out. But yeah, So there's one of the new radius arms. Look at that. Yeah. There's the new discs. Look at that. Looks a lot better under here now, doesn't it? So yeah, good, good. Just the other one to do. Connect the exhaust. Then do the brake cable that I've got a new one for. But I have to disconnect it in the car because it's terrible. I can't seem to undo it. So I'm going to just take the whole unit out, I think, but I'm going to do that when I drop the car off the jack. And then I'm still waiting for it, but my fuel pipe, yeah, look at the state of that. I hope they come off. I really hope they come off all right. Let's hope. And then I've got to connect all these sensors back up, but that's not too bad. Good. Sorry, there they are. Marvellous. Right, let's go. So that's there's the other radius arm on. That's good.
And I've just got the new exhaust on, the new back box. So like I say, this bit here is only about 4 or 5 year old. And you can see that this pipe here, this petrol pipe, has been leaking for years. I've always noticed a drip on there, but look, it's actually black on the exhaust pipe. You know, and I've only just put this back on, remember? It hasn't been dripping on this until like 10, 15 minutes ago. So you can see it's been dripping on there for a long time. So that's not very good. Heat and a petrol pipe. This is probably a good job we are doing it then. So yeah, I'll just hope they come off all right. But yeah, we get in there. I've got the other exhaust pipe to do the other side. But that'll probably be tomorrow, to be honest. And yeah, look at that. What a beast. Good. So I've taken my handbrake unit out. Okay, so this is, you can see where I tried to undo it, but yeah. Rubbish. Yeah. So this is how I've had to do it. Unfortunately, this spring piece fell off somewhere. I don't quite know how that went on yet, so we'll work that one out later. But yeah. Not good. Not good. No wonder I couldn't get it out. Alright, let's get it cleaned up. So, getting there. There's exhaust. Oh, there you go. Getting there. Now, I have fitted the handbrake. It's the first time the handbrake's ever worked, I think. First time the handbrake's ever worked. I've just got to bolt it all back together again, put the carpet back. But yeah, very impressed at the minute, very happy. But fortunately, I forgot to video me doing the handbrake, I'll be honest, because I got a bit carried away with it and then I forgot. So yeah, I just put my exhaust tips on. So good. Oh, I've got the petrol pipe off. I had to cut it off this end and take the I don't know what you call it, but it's yeah, this end wasn't too bad, but this was an absolute nightmare. I cut it off and let all the petrol drain out. It sort of turned into a fountain at one point, all little pinholes everywhere. I disconnected it in here. There it is. So, like I said, there's all little pinholes in this. There's one. So I disconnected this from the car and under it in a vise because it was a bit easier. So yeah, one more side to go and that looks like the worst. Here we go. Just to beware, yeah? As I was doing that, I was lying under the car and I ended on that other one. I actually got doused in petrol, yeah? So it'd be a big mistake to light a cigarette or anything right now. But yeah, just be mindful, yeah? Do not light a cigarette or any fire of any kind when you're doused in petrol, yeah? Oh dear. Oh, it stinks as well. It's a good job petrol smells nice, isn't it? So this one now. Oh my goodness me, here we go. So I've done the same with the other one. I've just got to disconnect the pipe off the car. And yeah, but we're virtually done now. Oh, the interior is all back in. So that's all nicely done. Handbrake, brakes, pads, everything. All I've got to do is put one split pin in there because obviously I have to go and get a new one. I've got to put brake fluid in, bleed the brakes, and fill the back axle up with oil, and put the two new pipes on, and away we go. Yeah, not bad. This is either end of the petrol line, so I've just got to undo that one. As you can see, I've undone that one, so then I'm just now waiting for the new pipes. But yeah, look at all this. There's my handbrake cable, look at that. I'm very happy with all of this. There is a bit of muck on the discs, but it'll burn off, won't it? Yeah. Very nice. So there's the other one off. So now, we're just waiting upon the new ones. Yeah. So these are the new fuel pipes. Yeah, look at them. Very nice. I managed to get these a bit cheaper, actually, so that's good. I think I paid £80 for the two with the postage. Right, it's the cheapest ones I could find online anyway, so. Yeah, let's get them fitted. And we're nearly done the car now.
So there we have, it's all done. I've just been out for a test drive, just to try it out. Yeah, there's my new, I don't know if you can see it, but there's the new fuel pipe. So very good. Very happy. Yeah. But that is what you call a difficult job. So now I've just got to clean up. Oh my goodness, there's another half a day just in this, but yeah, it's good. Beautiful, beautiful. Now I've got to wash it as well, actually.
Thank you for watching. I tried to film as much as I could, but I'm not very good at it, really. I sort of get carried away, and then I think to myself, oh, I missed that bit. but yeah, so if you're thinking of changing the rear brake discs on the back of your XJS, okay, if you've got a ramp, I would say it was fairly easy. All right. But I did this, as you saw, off a trolley jack and just propped it up with some wood and dragged it out onto gravel, which is a nightmare if you've ever done anything even similar to this. But yeah, I've never done it before. That was my first time doing an XJS. But yeah, that is. I will tell you now, that is hard work, yeah? So if you're thinking of doing yours and you don't know if you're really up to it, probably get a garage to do it, yeah? Right, so that's it from me. I'll bring some more videos again soon of the XJ6. There is a couple of other jobs I want to do on the XJS yet, so I'm not sure which one I'm going to do first. I don't know. So yeah, see you all soon. Thank you again for subscribing to my channel. I mean, I appreciate it. I can't believe I've got 71 people subscribed. It's like, wow. When I started doing this, I only had 5 and I thought I was doing well then. Thank you for all the comments, sharing, liking, all what you do. So yeah, until next time, see you later.